another thing that was interesting to me from folklore.
Folklore?
From folklore. Particularly in Poland, Czechoslovakia, Hungary. Was they had a puppet type, rod puppet, you call it. A rod puppet. Stick puppet. Sometimes it could be like a broom with a costume. And it was using folk dances. And it gave me a good idea about another style, another exercise. And this is like the start of it. So here is its head with a stick. And the circular material. This is use of science, really, by the center of gravity. And there's a very famous essay by a German called Kleist, who wrote a very nice piece about, he called it the marionette, the puppet on the strings. But it was really, he made an analysis between the dancer, the classical dancer, where every movement came from the spine. And that the spine was like a stick. And every movement came from the spine. And so this is an example of a puppet technique. There are no mechanics at all. Sometimes we can put little wire loops so that the puppet could handle. And we often talk about the puppet is just poetic, lyrical. And most of these puppets you've seen are really folk style.
Folk style.
And so I invented another kind of rock puppet. This technique you have to learn that we call split concentration. Because sometimes we must play with two characters. And so we have to have the different character style. So this hand has to think differently to this
hand.
And so one little trick, for instance, this puppet walks with its shoulders. So that the eye is always focused. So the flow of movement exists. But it's my hand that's thinking about the wall.
And so,
it's movement not there. And so then I can concentrate on the eye line focus and the direction. So it's another complicated. Sometimes when we make operas and ballets, we have another actor will work with feet. And sometimes, if you want bigger expressive movements, it's like Monaco, where the principal. Yeah, all right. It's like when you're a master and split responsibilities. Sometimes if you want to make ballets and operas, this is the best kind of figure, and then you can, with three actors, all this kind of movements, so it's more interesting. But sometimes you want to make something maybe from classic theatre, of Italy or something. And this puppet isn't, it's too elegant. Shall we make another? This is a very similar in some ways to the one we just saw.